Here we're going to show how the dollar signs are used in Excel to differentiate between absolute and relative referencing. In this example, we've got some sale products, we've got their cost of sale percentage, and at the moment, we've just created a link looking at the relevant cost of sale percentage. For now, let's just change these grid lines here. I'm going to show them as dashes, and you'll see why just now. We've now got this link here. I'm just going to draw a picture which shows you exactly the shape that attaches this cell to that cell there. So now you can clearly see that this cell's formula is equals B2, no dollar signs, and it is linking to that cell. In Excel, if we now decide to copy a cell like this, so I'm going to copy it and perhaps paste it over here. Excel has to make a decision. At the moment, it's looking from this cell to that cell, no dollar signs in that cell there. So where must this cell look? And what Excel does is it looks at the relative position of where it is, and effectively it does the following. Takes the length and shape, and it now knows that if it was here looking at B2, when it moves to here, that line must be exactly the same length and angle. And as a result, you can see that this cell looks at cell D3, which is over here, which you can see is over there. What happens now if you add dollar signs? So we're going to just delete this and the relationship. And over here, if I put a dollar sign in front of the B, it is as if Excel has said, because you've put a dollar sign in front of the B, now there are two borders here, and this reference is not allowed to go out there. The B can never change. Let's put a dollar sign in front of the 2. Now, it is as if there are now two solid lines on the second row because Excel will not allow this reference to move outside of row 2. So you now have a matrix. So if I had to now copy and paste it, what Excel wants to do in a similar position to last time is that. However, it knows that because of the dollar signs, this cannot be outside of the second row, and because of the dollar sign on the B, it has to stay within the B. And as a result, it has to continue to look at this cell no matter what happens. Let's go back here and just delete this. And now look at what will happen if, instead of copying it with a dollar sign in front of the letter and the number, we only have a dollar sign in front of the letter. In this case now, the solid lines are on the letter. So if we copy and paste, what Excel would like to do is to look over here. However, although it's allowed to move up and down across the rows, the solid lines means it cannot come out of the B, and so effectively it has to look there. Let's remove this quickly. And now we're going to remove the dollar sign from the B, but put it on the 2 only. Now Excel knows that the row must stay static, but the columns can move. So when we go copy and paste, again, what Excel would like to do is that. And although it's allowed to move the columns, so the B can change to a D, it has to stay within row 2 because of the dollar sign on the 2. So effectively, it needs to look there. So if I delete this, in this example, I want to create a formula over here and create it once so that when I copy it across, it always refers to the correct percentage. But when I go down, it must move in line with this. In order to achieve that, I believe we need to put the dollar signs on the B. And now, when we copy it across, what Excel wants to do with, for example, that cell, is it wants to move it that way. But because we've put the dollar sign on the B, it's not allowed to. So it has to continue to look there. And if we copy it down, this cell here, it wants to move it down. So it wants to do that. And in this case, that's fine. It is allowed to because it's not breaking out. But over here, if we look where it's looking, again, it would have liked to have gone and looked at that cell. But because of the dollar sign in front of the B, it's not allowed to. And as a result, it is forced to look here.